Chronemics is the study of the use of time. So the way we use time isn't verbal, so it's nonverbal, and it does often communicate something. So chronemics is a nonverbal way to communicate, and it is the study of the use of time. So there's two different types of chronemic behavior. We have a continuum. On this end, we have monochronemic, and on this end, we have polychronemic. So monochronemic means one thing at a time, and over here is polychronemic, and it means multiple things at once. So it is a continuum, and some cultures fall more on the monochronemic side, and some fall more on the polychronemic side. So think about the expressions that we have about time in our country. So we have things that are said like time marches on, and time waits for no man, and time is money, and time is of the essence. So there's a real urgency in the use of time in our culture. And think about how we organize our time in the day. If you were going to make a plan, and you were going to go to the stationery store or get on your phone and use an app, how would the stationery be segmented? How would your app segment your time? Would it have one thing at a time, or would it have a way to put, like, in the morning we'll do these things, and the so that it will, could be potentially many things at once? In America, we segment our time one thing at a time. So we will have one class at a time, and it will be over at this time and start at this time. And sometimes in those date books, it's broken down into like the 15 minutes. So I will do this for 15 minutes and this for 15 minutes. I'll block off this 45 minutes to do such and such, right? It's not uncommon to be so in a rush and so urgent that we can't stop the time to take a break in our country. There's like a real push with time in our country. So for example, in some cultures it would be more common, like when I was in Italy this summer, the towns would just shut down for like 2 hours in the middle of the day. All the shops would close, even like the coffee shops and stuff would close. And that would never happen in the United States. In fact, as the years go on, we find ways to squeeze more and more time out of things. For example, a long time ago, malls were closed on Sundays, and now they're open. So we push time and how we use time further and further and further. In America, it's not uncommon to eat at your desk instead of taking a break and going and living and doing other things. So that's one key part of America, is that there's a real push in time. There's a real like faster, do more, more, efficiency, efficiency, efficiency. And at the same time, we do like one thing at a time. We segment time and work one thing at a time. Now there are some exceptions and in our culture. For example, stay-at-home moms or moms when they're at home are doing often, or parents in general really, are multitasking. So there might be helping a kid with homework and doing the laundry and cooking dinner and kind of stopping and going and do this, do that, do this, do that. And there's maybe a tendency to globally in the whole world move more in that multitasking direction. Also, statistically, women are more efficient multitaskers than men in the most recent studies. And then I also just read a study last year about how people think that they're really good multitaskers, but they're actually, it reduces their efficiency quite a lot. They had someone doing three things, trying to have a conversation on the phone where they were, I think, solving a math problem and driving all at the same time. and they weren't great. Nobody could really do it. So multitasking can sometimes take away efficiency. And so the whole study of all of this is chronemics. So let's talk about how we use chronemics to communicate. So when we're late to something, what does that communicate? It really depends on what we're late to. If we're late to a job interview, it communicates that we're not really interested, or that we won't be a good employee, that we shouldn't really be considered for the position for one reason or another. If we're late to a party, sometimes that can just be the way it is. If it's a dinner party, you should try to be closer to, like, if someone's feeding you or there's like something that's happening at the party on a timeline, then you're typically try to be there closer to the beginning. But if it's like a late party where everybody's partying, if you get there at 8 or 9, you'll be there all by yourself for a long time. So it's how we use time. In other cultures though, say we schedule a meeting, that can be just sort of a suggestion. We'll get there around 8 o'clock. Whereas in American culture, the rule of thumb is often for most people to be there 5 minutes early. Like 5 minutes early is on time, so that you can be there and present and ready to start at the appointed starting time. But like I said, in other cultures, the American might show up 5 minutes early in order to be ready and prepared and start exactly at 8 o'clock, and the other person might be in the building, might be parking their car at 10 after 8 and thinking, yes, we had a plan to meet this morning. That is more of a polychronemic mindset of and also, I know poly means many, but the idea of time is fluid and movable is polychronemic. So there might be many things scheduled for the morning, and meeting times are just a sort of a suggestion. That would be a polychronemic kind of culture. And a monochronemic is, we'll be here right when it starts because we're only going to do it for 15 minutes or 30 minutes and then we're stopping and doing something else. So we use time in a variety of ways, and it's very culturally dependent.